The Lewis and Clarke recording session had a lot of hidden risks. There were a lot of aspirations for the recording that bring with it potential downfalls. Things like tracking the song entirely live. Things like recording an upright bass, potentially painting yourself into the corner of the lead vocal being the original scratch vocal from the tape.
When there's a session like this where the musicians really want to focus on a live performance, that mindset can sacrifice the quality of the recording just because of how you have to engineer the session.
As a producer, you really are supposed to be able to see into the future and see the potential pitfalls, to sort of bring as many of those things under control as possible. So I guess the idea will be just we'll get you guys all to run through the song a bit and kind of acclimate, and that'll be a good way for us to sort of patch in a million billion things. We came in the morning and we wanted to do what we typically do, which is to set everybody up live so that we can hear the song performed and we can from that decide what our approach is gonna be. What is that? It's weird. It turned out to be incredibly difficult to set up for that live off the cuff take. Incredibly difficult. We absolutely couldn't get the bass sound. If we could take a few minutes and just get the bass sound, cool. If you guys don't mind. This is like a perplexing one. I've sort of.
You could try putting a microphone right here.
We were mounting things in the bridge of the bass. We were trying to take a direct signal out and going into an amp.
Is the issue in the direct line? It's just what they have now, sounds like.
I can't really tell. Things that usually work quite well weren't working at all.
Well, it might make sense because we need to isolate this.
Right.
And we need to isolate Lou. I mean, because it'd be great to, that mic that's right behind you, the 440, the ribbon mic there, that would be like the mic of the century on the bass.
So then we sort of slowly just started separating everybody out. You know, Lou is now isolated in the isolation room. And Anthony was now isolated in the control room. We were able to put the AEA A440 right up on the bass, and that was it.
It sounds really, really righteous, actually.
Yeah.
How far we went to do that, we just realized, like, okay, we're recording this. We're not gonna get the off-the-cuff live version of how they do it. We're not gonna do that, we're just gonna go for it.
Lead vocal, we used the Neumann U67. That went into a pre on the MCI console and was compressed with the DBX 162.
Try not to bonk you in the face. Try that.
It's very unusual to keep a scratch vocal as your lead vocal take. Very unusual. It's probably only happened for me maybe twice in my life.
Are you hearing yourself okay in there in the phones?
Only the vocals.
You want the guitar louder?
Please.
Try this. I just put the DI in. See if that helps.
He really wanted to capture the live vocal take. He wanted that enough that we didn't do it to a metronome. We didn't do it to a click track. Whether we knew it or not, we were committing to recording a live vocal.
Yeah, let's try it. You ready?
And your heart knows the silence and the secrets it saves and the treacherous tension you think you deserve is your fate.
Lou's singing style is purely emotional. It's all based on, you know, miniature sort of performance fluctuations like holds or rushes in the vocal. There's no mechanism for reproducing that with any certainty.
We'll keep it safe, honest, I swear, then you'll be.
That's good. It sounds like you know what you're doing. Cool. Do one more like that and we're probably great.
If it was a bad vocal performance, we would have been out of luck. But luckily, it was a good vocal performance. it ended up saving us hours later in the day because we didn't end up spending any more time on the lead vocal than we did the basic tracks.
For the strings, we had the Elam 260s in XY stereo configuration, and then we also had the AEA R84s set up behind musicians as stereo grid mics.
Okay, so let me sing that. Eve, what's the beginning of that low harmony, real quick?
There's a humongous danger in bringing in classical musicians who have never played with one another, particularly if they're not reading off of a score. But even then, it's incredibly dangerous. It almost never...
Can we try that again? Can we start again?
Isn't that the end of our break? No, it's four times. Oh, it's right, it's four at the beginning. Okay,
I was going to for number three.
Oh, so you want us...
Ladder.
Yeah, we'll switch it there.
All right.
There's a whole set of variables that sit outside of what rock musicians ever have to think about. There's intonation. I mean, you're literally playing instruments that don't have frets. There's tone. A group of people who have never played before and who aren't reading off a score is highly likely to result in a no. You know what we could do? We could do two takes of Anthony and Eve and just like back to back and have Eve switch chairs so the two on top of each other would sound like two basses and two cellists. What we decided to do was to have Eve and Anthony lay down the sort of like basic no-frills arrangement of the song. 90% of what we used for the strings were those basic core parts that Eve and Anthony laid down. Their bowing, their tone, it came together perfectly. We're about to like set a record on like the fastest shaking through ever recorded. Everything worked out great. All the things that could have been pitfalls worked in our favor. They didn't end up leading to our undoing. And in the end, it was recorded incredibly quickly. And everybody was really happy. And everybody was really happy with that thing that they wanted in the first place, which was to get the right people in the room and to make a recording out of the talents and the spirit and enthusiasm of those people. Shaking Through is produced by Weathervane Music, a nonprofit dedicated to supporting independent music and the community that surrounds it. Your support helps sustain this series, which creates bold new art and resources to inspire the independent music community. To get involved, go to weathervanemusic.org.